gang. Welcome to Kid Life. Ignite. Man, look at that flame. Ooh. Hey, Kid Life Ignite, before we get started, you know what we got to do. We got to pray. Go ahead and bow your head and close your eyes with me, okay? Lord, we thank you today for all my friends that are watching here at Kid Life Ignite. I pray we have an absolute blast learning so much about you, God. Ignite our hearts so that we can learn so much about you. We thank you so much. In your name we pray. Amen.
Hey, kids, what time is it?
Let your glory fill of Jesus. Lift the name of Jesus. Lift the name of Jesus. All over this place. Lift the name of Jesus. Lift the name of Jesus. Lift the name of Jesus.
Mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their splendor. All this I will give to you, he said, if you will bow down and worship me. Jesus said to him, away from me, Satan, for it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Jesus says to Satan, worship God only. See, we all worship something. We all give our attention and our focus to something. Maybe it's material things or people. But we're supposed to worship God only. Are you distracted by something right now? Maybe there's something that you're thinking about that isn't God or his goodness. Instead of those things, let's focus on him right now. Let's worship God only right now.
Caught up in my feelings. I'm trying to play it safe, but the safety is just an illusion. When I'm called to be fearless, so here I come, I wanna follow where you're leading me. Time to let go, it's sink or swim now. So I jump.
Nothing can hold me back when you hold my hand. So I jump. Nothing. until you picked me up. You took me from nothing and gave me a purpose. Now my soul has a mission to tell of all you've done. Only you have the power to save. You're the truth, you're the life, you're the way. Heaven knows that I won't be the same.
Loop Show. I'm Tommy, and before we hang on for any loops, I was asked to come out and shoot straight with you. You may notice that our Loop Show desk is missing, and there's a rumor going around that we got rid of it because it smelled like honey and dead squid. That's simply not true. Truth is, our desk moved to Hollywood and got a job on a sitcom called Uh-Oh, Dad's a Desk. We'll always be able to say that we knew that desk back when it was covered in Cheese Whiz. We wish you well, desk. Now, who's ready for a new season? Hang on for the loop.
4, 3, 2, 1. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
I'm Ricky.
I'm Jamie.
And, you're trying on a new style, I see.
Oh, this. Yes, I've been watching old episodes, and I see how great you look in hats, obviously. So you influenced me to start wearing more hats.
That's such an honor, Jamie. I didn't know I had influence.
You do, and I do. We all have influence.
But are we all influencers?
Ooh, good question. Let's take a look at this.
When I was growing up, an influencer was often a teacher. It was a coach. A good parent was an influencer. A good friend was an influencer. Someone who led a Sunday school class was an influencer. And today, unfortunately, culture has hijacked the term, and many people say, well, an influencer is a celebrity, is a content creator, is someone who's amassed a great number of followers on social media. What I want to try to do today is I want to try to reclaim the word influencer. And I want you to see yourself as an influencer because you have no idea how our God could use one word of encouragement that you give to someone else, one moment or one expression of faith to change someone else's life. For those of you that are disciples of Jesus, I want to show you exactly what Jesus says you are. He uses two metaphors in Matthew's gospel, Matthew chapter 5. He says, you're also the light of the world. You're shiny. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand and it gives light to everyone in the house. It just shines. Darkness never overcomes the light. And Jesus says, you are light. In the same way, Jesus says, let your light shine before others. Let your love influence people toward Jesus. Let your light shine that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Let's reclaim the true meaning of what it is to be an influencer.
I guess I didn't realize how much influence I have on the people around me.
Mm-hmm. Oh, see, even Mystery Hannah's influenced by your style.
Okay, I should really be careful with all this influence. I want to make sure that it's shining a light.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of shining a light, let's check out this challenge. Yes, it's the Do You Know That Shadow Challenge. Can you guess the items behind the sheet based off their shadow? The winner gets a bright, delightful smoothie. The not winner gets a shadow smoothie.
Oh, no.
I bet there's like liquid smoke in that or something.
Shadow smoothie sounds so ominous.
Oh, it's the modeling figure that we have on the set with a cassette tape.
That was going to be my exact guess.
Oh, hey! Wow. Can you see it?
Yep, sure can. It's the last image I'll ever see.
Did I win? Oh, if you cover up the light, you can see it. Ah, it is indeed the modeling figure with a cassette tape.
Hooray! Next thing, please. Oh! Okay.
Oh, it's the jack-in-the-box with a toothbrush. The one that scared me.
Ah, and a trophy.
Oh,
ha!
Darn it.
It's the jack-in-the-box holding a trophy and a toothbrush.
I was going to make an additional guess, but ha-ha, hey! I recognize that guy.
No,
he scared me.
Know thy enemy. All right, so we are one-to-one.
You have a point,
I have a point. I have to be faster than Jamie. Okay, I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait for a full rotation. Okay.
It's a coconut with a little arm crutch in it.
Oh, Jamie, I think you need to really look at what coconuts look like. or a beanie, a little beanie.
Or it's a coconut.
I'm going to say it is fishing bait inside of a vase.
Fishing bait inside of a... I feel like I can't give up on the coconut now. So.
If it's a coconut, I will scream. So let's see.
Is that a coconut? It's a coconut! It's a coconut with fishing bait. What are the chances?
I don't think I've been more angry. Let's see that next slide.
He's so angry.
There's a coconut. Apparently, coconuts can look like whatever you want it to look like.
There's chicken feet.
This is a fashionable chicken dinosaur.
Chickasaur.
Thank you.
Yes.
And it is wearing a feather boa.
I'm going to stick with my American bald eagle with a bit of pine tree.
My final guess is it is a bird and or relating to a bird. Show me that bird. Oh,
it's an owl with a duster. Okay,
whoa.
So since I said it first, now that the sheet is up and neither of us were wrong, point.
No.
Oh.
I said a bird of any kind. And I said feather boa and feathers. So the panel of judges have ruled that I got that point on a technicality and... mostly God's grace. So we're tied. We are tied. That's the important thing. And this is going to be the tiebreaker. So show me that shadow.
Oh, it is a flashlight with a fake rubber snake wrapped around the handle.
It is a flashlight with a top hat. No, a teacup. It is a teacup.
Oh, I think I've lost. Bring me my shadow smoothie.
Show me that shadow. I won.
He did.
I won. Without a shadow of a doubt.
Oh, that was good.
So we all have influence, but how do we use it?
Hey, what's up, Loop? My name is James, and today we're talking about influence, right? So what is influence? Influence is nothing new. It's using what you have, what you think, and who you are to get people to follow you. So imagine this. Imagine I just gave you a YouTube channel with 1 million subscribers, right? That's your audience. What would you say to them? What would you want them to do? How would you influence them? All right, now imagine I gave you one person that was going through a hard time. They were in need. What would you say to them? What would you want them to do? how would you influence them? So here's the deal. If you want to have influence or be an influencer, there is no one better to learn from than Jesus. Why? Because Jesus lived 2,000 years ago, and he still, to this day, has more followers than anybody on Instagram or on YouTube, right? 2,000 years ago, those things weren't even invented yet, and Jesus still has the most influence of anybody in history. So Jesus was God in human form. That means he had all the power in the universe, but he never forced people to follow him. Instead, what Jesus did is he gained his influence by helping people that were hurting, by meeting their needs with mercy and with grace. The more Jesus met people's needs, the more his influence grew, and the more people wanted to follow him because people's lives were being changed for the better. So when the world gets dark, shine your light with mercy and grace. Use your influence like Jesus did. Use your influence to help other people, to serve those that are in need. Use your influence to not just build up your brand, but to build up other people. Now, you don't need a big audience to be an influencer. All you need is one person that you can help. And we all have that one person. So today, choose to be an influencer. Choose to use what you have, what you think, who you are, to help someone else. Stand up for a friend in need. Serve your parents. Be a good brother or sister to your siblings. I know it's hard, but it's worth it because you have influence. As a matter of fact, you have more influence than you think you have. Don't hide it. So today, how will you shine your light of leadership?
You are the light of the world, like a city on a hilltop that cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp, puts it on the baskets where no one can see it. Instead, you take the lamp, put it on the stand where it gives light to everyone in the house. And shine your light so everyone will know where it comes from. You are the light of the world, like a city on a hilltop that cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp and then puts it on the baskets where no one can see it. The same way, let your deeds shine out for all to see, so everyone will praise your heavenly Father. Shine your light whenever things get dark. Shine your light so everyone.
Thank you.
Oh boy.
Seriously, Tommy, do I have this much influence?
Oh!
I'm just wearing this because I saw Mr. Hand wearing it.
He is a trendsetter.
All right, Shadow Smoothie, let's see what
One,
you got.
1, 2, 3. Oh yeah, it's delightful. It's kind of like a little sherbet.
They just blended up beans and put it in a smoothie, guy.
Now,
it's starting to drip down the side. The beans are escaping!
Now, Jamie, explain to us, what blended and smoothied black beans taste like?
It's so gross. I'm like so sad right now.
Would it taste better if you were drinking it from the coconut cup?
That'll make me feel a little bit better. All right. It still tastes bad. So I'm being told there are beans, there are olives, and there are licorice chunks.
And I assume all of them together can't taste great.
No. I'm chewing it. I'm chewing my smoothie. Look how long it's taking to like, ugh, you can actually hear it drip. Gross. Beans for days.
Turn it around. Look at how chunky it is on the side.
Oh, there's like a huge chunk of black beans here that I don't think got blended up very well.
Hey, listen, Jamie, in solidarity, we will just drink
yeah.
as much as we can for like 5 seconds, okay?
Okay. Just in case.
All right. 1, 2, 3. it's really sweet, you know? It's like almost too sweet, kind of. How about you, Jamie? Oh, no. Oh, Jamie, no. To spill the beans, how does it taste?
It's really, really awful.
You kind of have like got a little
goatee.
Yeah.
I mean, if we're going for it.
Go for it.
I try not. Oh, I did it.
And now it joins your little chin beard. look at me. It looks great, Jamie.
I have my pinky up like this is some kind of fancy drink. I think my finger's just trying to get further away from the shadow smoothie. So, if we all have light, what do we do with it?
There are an infinite number of words in the world, yet only a few of them fit together to tell your story. Those are your words. Use them, own them, write them, say them. Start like this. I was, but God, and now. Tell this story. I was in the dark, but the light came for me, hunted me down, stared me in the heart and said, I dare you to find something better. I promise I won't let you down. Or maybe this is your story. I was exhausted, burnt out on religion, but the light came for me, and now I am free. Our story is incomplete without your chapter. Don't cost us your missing voice. We were commanded, let your light shine before others that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. You see, we don't believe that good deeds just earn us a pat on the back. We believe good deeds actually shift culture. So we light up, switch on, go out, tell them. And with each one that encounters our stories of light, we will shine brighter and brighter in an ever-increasing brilliance until those in darkness are so blinded by the light that the only thing left to do is to join our tribe. See, they're all searching for new beginnings, middles, and brighter endings. You be the storyteller. You have permission from the most quoted storyteller of all time. Listen, it doesn't matter how big the world is, and I'm sorry, but no one cares for any excuse you may think you have, because what the world is looking for is light, and what you have is light. It's the cure for temptation, lack of fulfillment, the hopelessness, the thwarted plans, and the unexpected affliction, for what they think is a good time but only leaves them searching. So yeah, we will look the whole world square in the eye and say to culture, this is the message we have heard from him and declare to you, God is light. In him there is no darkness at all. Because the light came for me, hunted me down, stared me in the heart and said, I dare you to find something better. I promise I won't let you down. And when I couldn't get my act together, the light still covered me. And that is a story worth telling.
God is light, and you are the light of the... What in the world?
Smoothie?
No, the... whatever that is.
Oh, well, Jamie, you have influence too. If there's anything I learned this week, is that you never know what one little thing you might do that might make someone else change the thing that they do.
You're right. You need to use your influence wisely.
As followers of Jesus, we need to shine our light. Serve others.
Be a leader. There are people out there that need to see you shine like Jesus.
And until next time,
Enjoy the ride! I did not pick up my smoothie because I am...
No, you don't want...
I know why to drink
you
it.
You don't want to slosh that around. Also, going back to the coconut thing, so is that how coconuts grow in the wild?
You have influence, and God has chosen you to impact and influence the people around you to shine your light. Whether it's teammates, your siblings, you have that influence. So let me challenge you with this. What is one way this week that you can shine your light to those people around you? Let me pray for us. God, I thank you that you are a good God. We thank you that you have given us opportunity for us to shine our light for you. God, I pray that you give each and every one of these students the boldness and the courage to shine their light to those people around you and to use their influence for good. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm so excited to see how you use your influence this week.